Type of cracks and resin selection. Before starting the injection, an inspection of cracks should be conducted and appropriate injection resin selected. It's also worth paying attention to the causes of cracking to better understand their nature and choose the optimal solution. For dry cracks and those that conduct small amounts of water or seep occasionally, use the polyurethane resin ResinBau CrackFlex. It's a structure stabilizer with very good adhesion and elastic properties. This is a resin suitable for sealing dry and wet construction cracks, also against pressing water, but it should be used at times when it has a chance to bind before being washed out. It means 3 to 10 minutes. For wet cracks carrying small, medium, large amounts of water, use a ResinBau EasyInject, HydroGum, or for really substantial leaks, use the tamponite expansive resin WaterStoper. Remember that identifying the causes of crack can help ensure durable and effective solution to the problem, so it's worth paying attention to this with every damage repair. When you need to restore the original mechanical strength of the structure, or even increase it, apply the epoxy resin EpoxPower, which forms a strong and durable bond and also adheres perfectly to most building materials such as concrete, stone or steel. I have a small tip for you now that will speed you up your selection of the right resin. On the resinbau.com website, there are highlightable icons. If you find the product you are interested in, look at technical datasheet to learn more. Before we move on the next step, I suggest doing a test injection each time. Remember, all the resin I showed you today can be used with single part pumps. This means you can use them with equipment that has only one tank. I want to point out that CrackFlex is a two-part of polyurethane resin. It hardens with a chemical process, without needing water or measure. How fast it reacts depends on things like temperature and how much water is in the structure. On the other hand, products like EasyInject, HydroGum and WaterStoper need water or measure to work. About making crack connections more flexible, you can do second injection with CrackFlex resin after using EasyInject or WaterStoper, if your products need it. One reason for doing a second injection is losing some of the injection stuff in the gap because the resin gets sucked into tiny holes and small cracks around the main structure crack.